Dear students, welcome back to this session. In the last class, we have seen how binomial distribution is originated by Bernoulli distribution with the help of the result. Let us see that result first. If x1, x2, x3, x2, xn are n independently or n independently and identically distributed independently and identically distributed Bernoulli variables with common parameter p then their sum x equal to x1 plus x2 plus so on plus x of n is a binomial variable with the parameters n and p. With the parameters n and p. This is actually tells what is the relationship between Bernoulli and binomial variator. As well, we can say here binomial distribution is developed or originated from a Bernoulli distribution. It is derived from Bernoulli distribution. Next, like Bernoulli distribution, binomial distribution, it is also developed by a mathematician, Swiss mathematician called James Bernoulli. And also we have seen binomial distribution is a discrete theoretical distribution. It is a discrete theoretical distribution. Next, now let us see or let us define the two factors, binomial variator and the binomial distribution. So, definitions. If x is a discrete random variable, if x is a discrete random variable with the probability mass function. With the probability mass function, P of x is equal to ncx p power x q power n minus x, where x is equal to 0, 1, 2 up to n, 0 less than p less than 1, q equal to 1 minus p. Here, x is a binomial variate. Binomial variate. And the distribution of x. And the distribution of x is a binomial distribution. With the parameters n and p. Yes, that is here. Suppose defined binomial variate is a question, then we have to define like this. If x is a discrete random variable with the probability mass function, p of x is equal to ncx p power x q power n minus x, x is equal to 0, 1, 2 up to n, 0 less than p less than 1, q equal to 1 minus p. Here, x is a binomial variate. Suppose it is asked to define a binomial distribution, then the whole statement we must write just write as a definition of a binomial distribution. Now here, while studying the definition, you can observe we have to start with the discrete random variable. It is an important word because it is a discrete theoretical distribution. And once more word here, probability function is considered as a probability mass function, because we have seen the probability function of a discrete random variable is called as a probability mass function. So these two are important factors. Next up, let us see the different notations we used to write the probability mass function. Now first of n, what is n? N is number of trials, right? So n is number of trials, that is the number of times a Bernoulli experiment is repeated. It is considered as a n. Next, x is number of successors. Number of successors. That is, if a coin is tossed 10 times, then we are going to define number of hits obtained when the coin is tossed 10 times. Then head becomes a success and n equal to 10. How many hits you can, we can expect if a coin is tossed 10 times? That is 0, 1, 2, 3 up to 10. So 0, 1, 2, 3 up to, in general, it is a n. So here, the number of successors in that particular example may take values from 0 to n. So in generally, that is a 0 to n, and that is actually represented by this term. This factor is called as a range, right? Range is the values taken by the random variable x, that is nothing but the number of successors. What is NCX? NCX is a combination factor. It indicates in how many ways X items are selected from N items. NCX. Next, remaining factors P and Q. What is P? Like Bernoulli, P is nothing but probability of success. What is probability of success? Probability of a Bernoulli variable X takes value 1 is called as a probability of success. Similarly, what is Q? Q is probability of failure, or that is probability of X equal to 0, which is equal to Q. There are all those factors we have seen. So these are the meanings of different factors or annotations we are going to write in the PMF of a binomial distribution. So here P is the parameter. Then these two factors are remaining. 0 less than P less than 1. It is actually the range of parameter P. Specifically we are going to call later it as parameter space. P lies between 0 and 1. It never take value exactly 0 as well as exactly equal to 1. Just less than 1 and just above 0. The next one. Q equal to 1 minus P. This is a Q plus P equal to 1. Sum of the probabilities is equal to 1 because of that, that condition. Next up. So, next C here. Suppose a random variable X, if it follows a binomial distribution with the parameters N and P, then we can write symbolically as X follows binomial, in bracket n comma p. X follows binomial in bracket n comma p. How to read? X, that is a random variable, it follows a particular distribution. If it follows binomial, we are going to write it as a b in bracket. Always the parameters should be written. So inside the bracket, always whatever may be the distribution, we must mention the parameters. Here it has two parameters, n and p. So this is the representation. Remember, suppose a random variable follows a Bernoulli distribution, then we are not going to write it as a b. Both starts from b itself. So if you want to write Bernoulli, we are not going to write it as a b. So anywhere or everywhere, if you are going to observe this b, it is not a Bernoulli, it is always a binomial distribution.
Examples for binomial variate. Now first example. Number of heads obtained when a coin is tossed 3 times. Number of heads obtained when a coin is tossed 3 times. Now we know then here a random variable x takes how many heads? We can write here, that is you are going to throw 3 coins at a time. The possible values that x can take are 0, 1, 2, 3. That means those throws may show either 0 head or 1 head or 2 heads or 3 heads. So x takes values 0, 1, 2, 3. With the respective probabilities, P of x is equal to 0, probability of a number of heads is 0, is equal, is nothing but 1 by 8. For that you just recall s is equal to HHT, and so on. How many outcomes are there? 8 outcomes you will be getting. So here you studied this earlier. 1 by 8 you will be getting. Similarly, probability of x takes value 1, that is 3 by 8. X is equal to 2, 3 by 8. X is equal to 3, 1 by 8. And total probability you will be getting as a 1. So here, a number of heads obtained when a coin is tossed 3 times. It is an example for binomial variate. This table represents the binomial distribution. It indicates binomial distribution. Now, just to observe the difference between the Bernoulli variate example and binomial variate example. There I have given an example like this. Number of heads obtained when a coin is tossed once. Only then you are getting only 2 values for x, 0 and 1. Then if you are going to write number of heads obtained when a coin is tossed twice, 2 times, then you can observe x takes values 0, 1 and 2. Then we cannot say here x takes only 2 values, it takes 3 values. So it is not an example for Bernoulli variate, but it is an example for binomial variate. Similarly, number of heads obtained when a coin is tossed 3 times, 4 times, 5 times, whatever may be the number of times you are going to repeat, all those are the examples for binomial variate. Yes, next, similarly, the next example, number of female children in a family with the 2 children. Number of female children in a family with the 2 children. That is, we have to consider the family. Different families when there are only 2 children, only a family with the 2 children. Now then, what are the values taken by these random variable? Suppose there are 2 children. Now suppose both are female, x take value 2. Suppose one is male and another one is a female, then number of female children become 1. Next, suppose both are males, then we can write there are 0 female children. Is it right? Now here, how many values it will take? X take, that is a number of female children in a family when with the 2 children. It takes 3 values, 0, 1 and 2. Then with the respective probabilities, that is according to the given instructions, we have to write the probabilities. So here once again observe the Bernoulli variate. Here number of female children in a family when there is a birth, then a random variable takes only 2 values. It is an example for Bernoulli variate. If it a family with the more than 1 child, if you are going to study, then that is an example for binomial variate. Similarly, maybe number of male children in a family with the 3 children, 4 children. You can write any example for binomial variator. We can give many other examples also. Number of bombs hitting a target when 5 bombs are aimed at a target. Number of bombs hitting a target when 5 bombs are aimed at a target. Now here x takes 6 values, 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. So it is not an example for Bernoulli variate, it is an example for binomial variate. Everywhere you can observe, if a Bernoulli experiment is repeated more than once, if a Bernoulli experiment is repeated more than once, you are moving to binomial variate. So while writing examples for Bernoulli variate and binomial variate, you must be very careful. You can give any number of examples. Number of tails obtained when a coin is tossed once is an example for Bernoulli. Is more than once, you can write 2, 3, 4, 100 if you want, you can write. It is an example for binomial variate. So similarly, we can give any number of examples here. That is a fourth one. We can write related to die. The number of 3s obtained when a die is rolled 10 times. That is also an example for binomial distribution. And similarly, the number of defective items in a sample of 5 items. This is also an example for binomial variate. So I have given now 5 to 6 examples. Try to understand the concept and try to understand the difference between Bernoulli and binomial. Next, let us write the binomial distribution. That is a binomial distribution or probability distribution of a binomial variate. Now, what is a binomial distribution? It must be written in the form of a table. Then first row is a random variable x, second is a p of x. Now to write the values of x, we must recall the range of binomial variate. What is the range? It takes n plus 1 values starting from 0, 0, 1, 2, 3 up to n. These are the values taken by the random variable x here in a binomial distribution. So corresponding to 0, I must write the probability p of x by looking at the probability mass function n c x p power x q power n minus x. Now first one here, this factor I have to write here. Put x is equal to 0 in this probability mass function. X is equal to 0 and all other factors write as it is. That is n c 0 p power 0 q power n minus 0. Substituted, x is equal to 0. The next value of x is 1. Now put x is equal to 1, n c 1 p power 1 q power n minus 1. Next 0, 1, 2. That is n c 2 p power 2 q power n minus 2. Next we must write 3, 4, so on. The last value is n. Once again substitute n here, n c n p power n q power n minus n. We can simplify this also. That is n c 0, we have studied this as 1. Next p power 0, anything power 0 is 1. Q power n minus 0, that is q power n. So what is remaining? Q power n. Next is nc1, that is a n, p power 1, p, q power n minus 1. It remains as it is. Next is I'm not going to simplify. Similarly, last one, just to see, ncn. You can simplify. Ncn is 1, p power n, q power n minus n, that is q power 0, which is equal to p power n. Now here, this table, this is the table, we can call that as a binomial distribution of a random variable x with the two parameters n and p. Here, range is x is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 up to n. It takes n plus 1 values. How many values are there in the first row? That is n plus 1 values. Then, respectively, we can observe this distribution has n plus 1 probability terms. This distribution has n plus 1 probability terms. N plus 1 probability terms. What are probability terms? These are called as the probability terms. That is the factors which we have written in the second row, P of x, are called as probability terms. What is the first probability term? This term is called as first probability term. And this term is called as a second probability term. Then, do you know what it is, the last factor? Is it a nth probability term? No, it is not a nth probability term. Suppose I am going to write a factor here, n minus 1. Then, this factor is called as a nth probability term. And what about this? This is a n plus 1th probability term. Remember, this is a last term is called as a n plus 1th probability term. So, to write first probability term, put x is equal to 0 in the probability mass function. To write the second probability term, you just put x is equal to 1 in the probability mass function. Suppose you want to write fourth probability term, what is the value of x? So first means 0, second means 1 less, 1. Third term means you have to put this is a third term. Third term means put x is equal to 2. Then fourth term means put x is equal to 3. Similarly, n plus 1th term is obtained by putting x is equal to n. So this is what probability term indicate in a binomial distribution. Now here we have to note the binomial distribution has n plus 1 probability terms, and the successive probability terms, these are called as successive probability terms. So these successive probability terms of a binomial distribution are considered as successive terms of binomial expansion q plus p power n. This factor we are going to study in mathematics. Next, let us write a probability distribution of a binomial variate with the parameters n is equal to 3 and p is equal to half. Now in the same distribution, put n is equal to 3 and p is equal to half. That is, I can write x follows binomial with the parameters n is equal to 3 and p is equal to half. Next, the probability mass function is p of x is equal to ncx, 3cx, n is 3. Next, p power x, p is half, half power x, into q power n minus x, that is half power n minus x, n is 3, right? to write this, better to recall the probability mass function p of x equal to nc x p power x q power n minus x. I substituted the values. N is equal to 3, nc x, p power x, p is a half power x, q is half. Why q is half? Q equal to 1 minus p, that is 1 minus half, which is equal to half. So I wrote the half. So half power 3 minus x. Now by looking at this, try to write the probability terms. Now first one, n is equal to 3, I wrote. So x takes values. X takes values 0, 1, 2, 3. Now first value, X takes value 0. Respective probability term, I can write by substituting the value of X equal to 0 in this probability mass function. That is a 3C0 P power 0 into Q, half power 3 minus 0. First probability term. Next, second one, put X is equal to 1. X is equal to 1. Then in this, put X is equal to 1. 3C1. Next, half power 1 into half power 3 minus 1. I substituted X is equal to 1. The next term is X is equal to 2. That is 3C2, half power 2, half power 3 minus 2. 3 minus 2. Next, fourth term. Substitute X is equal to 3. 3C3, half power 3, half power 3 minus 3. Now, just to simplify, that is 3C0, 1, half power 0, 1 into half power 3, 1 by 8. After simplification, you will be getting 1 by 8 here. 3C1, 3 into half power 1, 1 by 2 into half power 3 minus 1, half power 2, that is 1 by 4. And the answer is 3 by 8. And the next one, 3C2, 3 into half power 2, 1 by 4, into half power 3 minus 2, half power 1, that is 1 by 2. Once again, you will be getting 3 by 8. And the last one, 3C3, 1, half power 3, 1 by 8. And half power 3 minus 3, half power 0, right? That is a 1. The answer is 1 by 8. Now add all the probabilities. 1 by 8 plus 3 by 8 plus 3 by 8 plus 1 by 8. You will be getting 1. Now this is how to write the binomial distribution for the given parameter values. That is, here it is given n is equal to 3 and p is equal to half. Similarly, we can write any distribution if the values of the parameters will be given. But remember always the sum of the probabilities must be equal to 1. Right? Here, this is the first probability term, second probability term, third probability term, and the fourth probability term. Next, let us study the features of binomial distribution. Let us study the features of binomial distribution. Now, as earlier, like Bernoulli distribution, the similar factors we have to consider as features. The factors are similar. Now, first one that we consider, Bernoulli distribution has a unique constant, that is a p, which is also called as parameter of the distribution. In the similar way, here also, the first feature we can write, binomial distribution has two parameters, n and p, which are also called as the constants of the distribution, where n indicates the number of successors and p indicates the number of sorry, the probability of success. N indicates the number of trials and P indicates the probability of success. Next, second one. So here the question may be like this. What are the parameters of binomial distribution? The parameters are N and P. It has two parameters. Next, the range of binomial variate is x equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 up to n. The range of the binomial variate is x is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 up to n. It takes n plus 1 values. And the third feature is the probability mass function is p of x equal to ncx p power x q power n minus x. X is equal to 0, 1, 2 up to n, 0 less than p less than 1, q equal to 1 minus p. This is called as the probability mass function of a binomial distribution. Already I told what are the meanings of those factors here. And fourth one, the mean of a binomial distribution is a np, variance is a npq, and standard deviation is square root of npq. In the earlier you have seen in Bernoulli, mean is p, variance is pq, there is no n, standard deviation is a square root of pq, that is the mean, variance and standard deviation of Bernoulli distribution. Since it has repeated n times, you just think of, we must write a mean as np, variance npq, and standard deviation square root of npq. And as in the Bernoulli distribution, in the binomial distribution also, mean is greater than variance. Mean is greater than variance in a binomial distribution. That is in both Bernoulli and binomial distribution, mean is greater than 1. Mean is greater than variance. Mention the distribution in which mean is greater than variance. It is a one mark question. The answer is you can write either Bernoulli distribution or binomial distribution, because both satisfies it. Or we can say the relationship between mean and variance in a binomial distribution is mean is greater than variance. Next, the sixth feature, next one, that is if np is an integer, if np is an integer, then mean and mode are equal in a binomial distribution. If np is an integer, then mean and mode are equal in a binomial distribution. That is, imagine for example, n is equal to 6 and p is equal to half. Then what is a mean of a binomial distribution? Mean is nothing but it is given by the formula np. So mean equal to n into p, which is equal to n is 6 and p is equal to half, you will be getting 3. So mean of a distribution is a 3 here. So if np is an integer, now you can observe here the value of np is equal to 3, which is an integer. Which is an integer, then in a distribution always mode and mean are equal. So here in this example, mode equal to mean, which is equal to 3. So remember, always in a binomial distribution, if the value of np is an integer, integer means fractions are not allowed, decimal values are not allowed. So if this is an integer, then always in a binomial distribution mean and mode are equal. One mark question: when mean and mode are equal in a binomial distribution? The answer is if np is an integer. Next, the seventh feature, usually mode is nothing but the value of x which has the highest frequency, that we know. Similarly, in a binomial distribution, now imagine this is one of the example for binomial distribution. Here the sum of the probabilities is a 1. Now suppose it is asked to find what is the mode of this distribution. Here mode is the value highest probability first find, that is here the highest probability is a 0.4 and the corresponding value of x is 2. So here in this example we can say the value of mode is a 2, because in the binomial distribution mode is the value of x corresponding to the highest probability. So here mode is nothing but the value of x which has highest or maximum probability. I think it is clear. First, in a probability distribution, find which is the maximum probability and look at the respective value of x, that is called as a mode, right? So that is a next seventh feature of a binomial distribution, that is a the mode of a binomial distribution is nothing but the value of x which has the highest probability.